Welcome to the perfume counter. Is there anything in particular you're looking for today? Okay, so not quite sure, but you're looking for a new fragrance. Perfect. Well, in that case, a good place to start is here at our top shelf where we keep all of our current bestsellers. So you can peruse on your own, or if you like, I could walk you through, tell you a little bit about each of them. Do you have any likes or dislikes when it comes to your fragrances? Like any preferences towards more sweet or more spicy, warm, musky, anything like that? Does tend to be what most of our most popular fragrances lean towards, so you're in luck. The first one I'd like to show you is probably my most worn fragrance personally. This is Black Opium by YSL. I would describe this as an intoxicating, warm, and spicy fragrance. I think would be best described as an amber vanilla. I find it to be perfect for evening events like dates, dinners, weddings, that sort of thing, because it is a quite intimate scent. Opens with adrenaline-rich coffee and sweet sensuality of vanilla, reclining into the softness of white flowers for a modern, seductively warm twist. The top notes are pear, pink pepper, and orange blossom. Middle notes are coffee, jasmine, bitter almond, and licorice, with base notes of vanilla, patchouli, cedar, and cashmere wood. The bottle, as you can see, is dark, decorated with sparkles that give it this sort of like glam rock look they were going for. And then there's a window in the center where you can see the attractive corally pinky shade of the fragrance. And then it has the name written here, Black Opium. The brand is written there. I'm always very impressed with the lasting power of this one. I only need a spritz or two and I still smell just as strongly of it at the end of the night as I did at the start of my morning. And I get plenty of compliments. So, let's get you a sample of this bad boy. Do you think that this sounds like something you might like? Okay. Our sample bottles, so I like to ensure that each sample paper is as thoroughly sampled as possible. Let's see if that's good yet. You always want to make sure you give it a moment for the alcohol to dissipate away, so that you actually are getting a true read on the fragrance and not just smelling like rubbing alcohol scent, you know. This is a woody, spicy fragrance for men, actually. It's got a warm, woody, and spicy composition. Perfume, olive hair bulge, blended spices with sensual undertones, creating two diametrically opposed fragrant accords. The first logo. Looks like a wax seal. Isn't that cute? So the top notes of this one are pink pepper. That's very common because it's very good. Bergamot and grapefruit. Middle notes are cinnamon, saffron, and paprika. And the base notes are tobacco and leather. I think this one smells sexy on men and even sexier. Do notice the tobacco and leather that they talk about. It smells like a dive bar, but in the best way. So just give that a second again. How's your day going so far? Yeah. I hope that we'll find the right fragrance for you today. That's always so exciting. Everybody knows how strongly fragrances are associated with memories, that it's very powerful. It's important that you pick the right one, the scent that you want to be attributed to everything that's going on in your life right now. So, was that a good one for you? A bit too intense or a good fit? Okay, it's a maybe. So, the next one is Rose Jam from Lush. Bit of a different direction, moving away from designer. This is a floral, fruity fragrance. It's light and fresh, perfect for spring and summertime. The top notes are Turkish rose, rose oil, and marmalade. Isn't that cute? Middle notes are youthful, playful, innocent. Definitely one I tend to recommend to younger ladies looking for their first signature scent. What's next? This is the reigning queen, so extremely popular lately. No signs of dying down anytime soon. And for good reason. The top notes are lavender, blossom, juicy pear, and bergamot. The middle notes makes me feel like I'm taking a bubble bath. And the packaging just really couldn't be cuter. It's this beautiful baby blue with the cloud on the cup. And then the white cloud holder that I've heard some people use as a phone stand if they're filming a TikTok. Settle her back into her nest for a nap. Okay. Do you like that? Right? Yeah, there's a reason all the ladies love it. Okay, so for now, cloud and black opium would be considered your is the key ingredient, surrounded by orange blossoms, and finally jasmine at the heart. It has a pretty fruity opening of blackcurrant and pear, while the base is more warm and powdery due to the almond-like accords of tonka bean, praline, patchouli, and vanilla. So I really love perfumes that work that way. They've got those foundational base layers of the more warm, woody fragrances with the fruity sweetness on top, like the whipped cream and cherry on top. And I love this classy little necktie they've given her. That one really sugar lychee from Fresh. This one sparkles with delicate citrus, juicy lychee, and fresh mango. It's an exotic fragrance that warms with tonka bean and amber undertones. Feels like being on a tropical vacation, lounging out beneath the palm trees, the warm sun on your skin. And you can smell the salty sea breeze, your sunscreen, and your piña colada at your side. Oh, that's beautiful. Just makes me want to jump in the water. What do you think of that? Do you like it? Is that too sweet? beachy. Next, we've got Dylan Turquoise. In very cute packaging. I love the frosted blue glass. It looks like sea glass, doesn't it? It opens with a burst of Italian mandarin and lemon. It has art notes of guava, complemented by transparent jasmine petals and freesia. The bottle is an expression of the innovative design of Versace. The elegant curves are resurgence of Y2K. This is such a like Britney Spears, Paris Hilton-y, Lindsay Lohan-y fragrance. They say it's for young girls who like sweets. Very, very sweet fragrance that smells like fruity candy floss. The top notes are raspberry, orange, fig leaf, and bergamot. Middle notes are cotton candy, is sweet, 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 which some people love, others not so much. We'll see what you think.
Okay, what do you think of that?
A bit too sweet for your liking. Yeah, definitely can't blame you for that. And the next contender is You by Glossier. This one is often described as difficult to describe. First, you smell the pink pepper, the bright, sparkling, spicy top note that makes that good first impression. Then you get into the woodsy, slightly sweet. Kind of reminds me of laundry, freshly done laundry. And the packaging is neat. It's sort of like cloudy, milky, and it has this thumbprint where your hand just slots into it so perfectly, like it was made for you. I'd like to show you is very simple. Grenade's top note is citrus. The middle is pomegranate, raspberry, and blackberry. And the base note is musk. Nothing too complex, nothing too fancy here, but nothing to sneeze at either. It's pretty nice. Alright, so, do tell. I eagerly await your verdict. Which would you like to bring home with you?